In the same place, I lifted up my head and I saw two thrones, or two. They were both occupied. I asked the angel of the Lord who was sitting on both thrones. He said to me, "The first one you see is Abraham. He is the one sitting on that throne. And the second one you see is occupied, or is Moses, who is also sitting on that stool or throne." I asked the angel of the Lord if I was permitted to talk to any of the persons in that place. I wanted to talk to the people who were all wearing the same white garment and were very excited, happy, or joyous. He gave me the permission. Before I did that, I asked him again where this place was, or where I found myself, what the place is called. He said, "Here is paradise." He told me the place I found myself was paradise. He said, "Here are for those who died in the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the place where their souls come." He told me the place, which was made with glass building, with people wearing white, the same dress, and were all happy or excited or joyous. It was paradise, and it was the place for those who died in Christ Jesus. When they died, their souls come to this place. So I went on to ask one of the people who I told him how he managed to come to this place called paradise. So I went on and I asked one of the people in paradise. I asked him how he managed to find himself in this beautiful place called paradise. He said to me that he lived his life for Jesus when he was on earth. All the days of his life when he was on earth, he lived his life for Jesus Christ. He gave himself to Jesus and also obeyed the commandment of Jesus. He did not deviate from the truth. So when he went on to ask this person in paradise how he got into paradise, the person told him that he lived his life for Jesus Christ all the days of his life on earth. He gave himself to Jesus Christ and also obeyed his commandment and did not deviate from the truth. And so when he died, he found himself in this beautiful place called paradise. The man who was interviewing Kweku Gyimah asked him if he saw anybody he knew in paradise. And he said he did not see anybody he knew on earth in paradise. The angel of the Lord told me that my time was short, so they should hurry up because he had other things to show me. He told me to hurry up because he had other things to show me. He held my hands and we began to move from there. As we were going on the road, I saw something which surprised me a lot. I saw a group of angels who were seriously and also busy picking up some things from the floor or the ground. I saw a group of angels who were serious and they were also busy picking up some things from the floor or from the ground. They were picking up and putting these things into something like a sack or a bag. They were picking up things from the floor or the ground, and they were putting these things in a bag. It seemed as though when the bag was full, after picking up these things, they would lift up the bag and carry it and send it to the place where the angel was taking me, or the place we were heading towards. So they were busy and serious picking up some things and putting them in a bag. And then after that, they will lift it up and carry it and send it to the place where the angel was sending me or were heading towards. So I asked the angel of the Lord where he was taking me. I asked the angel, where are we going? The angel of the Lord told me, I'll find out when we get there. I cannot describe to you the kind of things these angels who were busy and serious picking up, the things they were picking. I cannot describe to you because I haven't seen anything like this on earth. But one thing I know is that they were very busy and they were very serious picking up these things. I cannot describe it to you. But they were busy picking up these things, putting it in this bag, and then lifting it up, carrying it, and then sending it to the place where the angel was taking me. The next group of angels we came across on the way was those who were also now bringing something out of the place we were going. The first group of angels, I told you, were picking up things, putting them in a bag, and sending it to the place we were heading towards. Now, the second group of angels, I realized that they were also bringing things, bags, back to from the place we were heading towards. They were bringing things from that place, and they were taking it to the place we just left. So the first group was taking things to the place, and the second group were taking things from that place back to the place we left. As we were still on our way to the place the angel was sending me, we also came across a group of angels. I saw a few of the angels working. This time around, I saw a few of the angels working, but majority of the angels were sitting down idle, doing nothing. Majority were doing nothing. They were just sitting down idle, doing nothing. And only few were busy working. So now I'm describing to you the first group of angels were picking up things, putting them in a bag and sending it to the place we're heading towards. The second group were bringing things from that place back. And then the third group were a few angels who were working hard, and majority of them were just sitting down idle, doing nothing. So I asked the angel of the Lord, how come the first group of angels were very serious and busy working and gathering things, and the second group of angels were also seriously bringing things back, and now with this third group, only few are working and majority of them are sitting down idle and doing nothing? I asked the angel this question. How come that the first group were busy working, the second group were also busy bringing things back, the first group was taking it there, the second group was bringing it back, but at this third group, few are only working and majority of them are just sitting down idle doing nothing? What's going on? I asked the angel of the Lord. After asking the angel of the Lord this question, this is his explanation to what I saw. He said to me that the first group of angels you saw gathering and putting things in the bag, what you saw them gathering were the prayers of the righteous believers or Christians. These were the prayers of the righteous which had arrived in heaven. And that's why the angels were now gathering the prayers of the saints. They were gathering these prayers which had arrived in heaven. So the first group of angels you saw, they were busy and seriously working because the prayers of the righteous believers had arrived in heaven. And so they were gathering them and they were taking them away. The second group of angels that you saw coming out from the place we're heading towards were answers to the prayers of the righteous. They were answers. their prayers had been answered, and so now the angels, after taking it in, now the prayers had been answered, so they were bringing it up out to these believers. So the first group of angels you saw, they were gathering the prayers. The second group were also bringing the answers to these prayer requests from the saints or from the righteous believers. Now, the third group of angels you saw, their responsibilities were to gather thanksgiving from believers from the earth. Their responsibilities were to gather thanksgiving, praises, thanksgiving, appreciation from the saints on the earth in heaven. So those you saw sitting idle, the angels you saw sitting idle in heaven, they were idle because they had nothing to work with, because the believers or the Christians or the saints were not giving God thanks. That's why they were sitting down idle. They had nothing to work with because there were no thanksgiving, no appreciation, no thanks coming in for them to work with. The few that you saw were those who were diligently working with the thanksgiving coming from the saints. They were gathering the thanksgiving. They were gathering the appreciation and the attitude of gratitude from the earth, from the believers. So this goes a long way to describe that the fact that when believers pray, their prayers are gathered, and then heaven angels bring answers. And angels sit idle when no thanksgiving is being rendered to God. Only few work, because majority sit idle because believers do not give them anything to work with, because they are not thanking or appreciating or giving thanks to God, their maker.